Welcome to your first e-foil lesson. I'm going to show you the easy steps, how to get up and how to start foiling. First, I will show you out here. You always start lying down on your stomach like this. Make sure you're in the middle of the board. Every person is different, so you might need to move forward or move backwards a little bit until you feel that the board is stable. From this position, you give a little bit of gas, and then you slowly get to your knees like this. You have the remote in your hand, so I always put my hand on the board like this, and then keep one consistent speed. From here, you first place your back foot onto the board, and you can take your time. It's not surfing, you don't need to pop up or anything. Take your time to then place your front foot next to your hand and stand up.
I'm going to show you in the water how to stand up and how to start foiling. Before we go, it's always good to mention or to check how far you are from the side. It might be a little bit more shallow on the sides. And of course, you have to know how deep it is in general. Always check the local regulations before you go e-foiling. It might be different wherever you go. And always check the speed on the remote by pressing the minus button and hold it until the remote vibrates. You unlock the remote, and here on the bottom there is a number, and that indicates the speed. This remote has 24 different speeds, so I advise you to always start on the low speed, like 10, to feel the board and see what that does. We also strongly recommend you to start foiling on a lake instead of the sea, for example, because there are places close by you can go to if something goes wrong. And with the waves, the ocean is for more advanced e-foilers, so that's something to work towards too. The first lesson is about getting comfortable with the board, learning how the board works. Therefore, the speed is important, as we just said. Also, when you fall, and it will happen, try to fall with the board, so away from the mast and the fin. And try to build it up very slowly. Then you will learn it faster and less accidents will happen. It's not extremely dangerous, but if you go too fast, you can shoot up, the board can go to one side and you can fall onto the mast or the fin. Also important, if you're over 100 kilograms, it might be too much for the board, so we strongly recommend to not go onto the e-foil if you weigh more than 100 kilos. Having said that, I think we can start. You always start lying down on your stomach. Important is to remember that every person is different, so when you start lying down, you have to feel for yourself a little bit if you have to move forward or backwards until the board feels stable for you. Make sure that you are in the middle of the board, and then you can go. Press and hold the minus button on the remote. Make sure your speed is not too high. And then just give a little bit of gas. If you want to stand up, start lying down, and then the next step is to get to your knees. You have to have one consistent speed. When you have that, you feel comfortable, you can very slowly get to your knees, like this. Once you're on your knees, the first thing you do is put your back foot on the board, maintain your speed, and when you feel stable enough, you put your front foot where your hand is, in the middle of the board, like this.